Hello everyone, here we are discuss about the next topic, that is mass multiplication of different entomopathogenic fungus. In that we discuss about the mass production of first entomopathogenic fungus, that is Verticillium. So let us see the procedure of mass production. The fungus is multiplied on cheap media for large scale production. We can use any media for the production of that fungus. The sorghum, second point, that is sorghum grains, which is free of pesticide residue, is washed in potable water. Sorghum grains we can wash with water and transfer into the conical flask, and 15 ml of distilled water is added. Then the conical flask are plugged with cotton and autoclaved for 15 to 20 minutes at 15 psi pressure, so that sorghum grains get sterilized in autoclave, because the function of autoclave is sterilization, so that the grains of sorghum get sterilized or microorganism free after autoclaving. Then the flasks are allowed to cool and transfer or taken into the laminar airflow chamber for inoculation. Inoculation means for transfer. From the clean uncontaminated mother culture of slant. Mother culture of slant means what? The fungus which is already grown in a test tube which containing media. Which fungus? That is Verticillium fungus is already grown in a test tube which containing media. So this is called as a mother culture of the Verticillium. In slant, slant means what? The test tube which is in horizontal position, and in that test tube we already grow the fungus, that is Verticillium. So this is called as a mother culture. So from clean uncontaminated mother culture in slant, full quantities of Verticillium lacani spores is transferred aseptically. Then this flask is directly we can plug with the cotton plug, the conical flask. The flask are incubated directly into the incubated at room temperature. The spores are obtained within 4 nights. That means within 1 or 2 days, the spores of Verticillium is multiplied on the grains of sorghum. So in that way we can multiply in mass quantity. We can increase our quantity depending on our requirement. The next one is mass production of second entomopathogenic fungus, that is Metarhizium, on carrot broth. Broth means liquid. So carrot, we can see the procedure. We can cut the carrot into small pieces, then it is washed in potable water and transformed into the conical flask, that is 250 ml of conical flask, and 15 ml of distilled water is added. Then the conical flask are plugged with cotton and autoclaved for 20 minutes at 15 psi. Similarly, we can autoclave the conical flask which containing the pieces of carrot along with the water. So for the sterilization purpose, we can autoclave that conical flask for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, the flask are allowed to cool and taken into the laminar flow chamber for the inoculation purpose. From the clean uncontaminated mother culture in slant, full quantities of the Metarhizium anisopilis spores are transferred aseptically into the another flask or the here. The flask are incubated at room temperature. The spores can be harvested in a fortnight. That means within 2 to 3 days there is a growth of Metarhizium fungus takes place. So the procedure of Metarhizium and Verticillium is somewhat same. Only here the grains are used, jowar grains or sorghum grains are used in case of Verticillium, mass production of Verticillium, and in case of Metarhizium, mass production of Metarhizium, we use carrot. Next, the mass production of Beberia is what? Same procedure. Carrot cut, or we can cut the carrot into the small pieces, that is 40 gram, carrot we have to taken and washed in potable water and transferred into the conical flask. And again we have to add the 15 ml of distilled water. Then the conical flask are plugged with cotton and autoclaved for 20 minutes at 15 psi as we discussed earlier. Then this flask is allowed to cool and taken into the laminar airflow chamber for the inoculation. Then same the from a clean uncontaminated mother culture in slant, lawful quantities of the Beveria bassiana spores are transferred aseptically into the conical flask. That means from the test tube which containing the Beveria fungus, so with the help of needle we can transfer that Beveria fungus from test tube into the conical flask. The flasks are incubated at room temperature. The spores are obtained in fortnight. Next, the mass production of Pneumoria culture we can grow on the sterile SMYA slants. That is, on slant we can grow the culture of Pneumoria fungus, and it is incubated at 25 to 28 degrees Celsius for 7 to 8 days. It was used for the preparation of spore suspension. Then spore culture was washed twice with sterile distilled water containing a wetting agent, that is the Twin 80 is the name of wetting agent, at a rate of 0.1%. Then washed the spores were reconstituted in fresh sterile distilled water containing 0.1% Twin 80 to prepare the inoculum. Then this suspension was then charged in Neobar hemocytometer slide to count the number of spores present. So the number of spores was adjusted to 1 into 10 raised to 7 spores per ml of suspension, and this suspension was used as an inoculum for further experiment. So this is about the mass production of Pneumoria. Next, the mass production of Pseudomyces fungus. Just we have to take the 100 ml of different liquid media, that is the PDA, that is PDB, potato dextrose broth, 10% of molasses, recharge medium and semi-selective medium. They were taken in 250 ml of conical flask. That media is taken into 250 ml of conical flask. Then that media or that conical flask is autoclaved at 15 psi for 20 minutes. Each flask was inoculated aseptically with 8 mm disc of the Pseudomyces fungus. That is, 8 mm disc of the Pseudomyces fungus is directly transferred into the conical flask. That is, which that flask which containing the PDA broth or potato dextrose agar as a pure culture. The flask were incubated at room temperature for 30 days. The fungus inoculated in semi-selective media is served as a control. So what happens after few days, there is a growth of Pseudomyces is obtained on that semi-selective media. So depending our requirement, we can multiply rapidly with by using the different again media. Last one is mass production of Hirsutella thompsoni. For the mass multiplication, Sobard maltose broth was found to better. That is, that media is used for the multiplication of Hirsutella fungus. Take the SMB media in conical flask. Plug the conical flask with cotton and autoclave for 20 minutes at 15 psi. Inoculate the flask with isolated Helicoverpa thompsoni. Hirsutella thompsoni. Incubate the flask for days or for 2 to 3 days. After that, there is a growth will observed, and after onwards, after the growth of such fungus, we can use for the further application. So this is about the total mass productions of different entomopathogenic fungus like Verticillium, Pseudomyces, then Beveria, then Hirsutella, etc. So if you have any difficulty regarding that topic, so you can ask me. Thank you.